as you meets an old immovable object like me. You can bet as sure as you live, something's gotta give, something's gotta give, something's gotta give. When an irrepressible smile such as yours forms an old impeccable heart such as mine, don't say no because I insist.
I am Duke Diakovich. I'm president of the Greater Kansas City AFL-CIO, and I am very honored to be presiding this morning. And thank you all very much for being here. The voters of our diverse city have elected these 13 individuals to come together and work hard to make sure our city remains what it has been in the last couple of years, one of the best places in the country to live. And and I would like to first acknowledge and thank the Staley Quartet, who those four young ladies gave up a Saturday morning in the summer to be here. And they're very talented and did a wonderful job. Thank you. And I'd also like to thank all of you who came down on a Saturday morning for this event. This is a very, very special event, and we're very happy that you could be here with us. Right now, I would like to ask those who are able to please stand as we have the presentation of the colors by the Kansas City, Missouri Police Department, Fire Department, and the United States Marine Corps. At the end of which, please remain standing. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce Bobby Watson. Bobby is a saxophonist, Grammy nominated, he's a producer and a composer, and is also a professor of jazz at the University of Kansas City, Missouri.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Mr. Watson, thank you very much. You know, arts and culture are a very, very important part of Kansas City's spirit, and you are a great representative of that. Thank you. Providing today's invocation is Pastor Gregory Ely from Paseo Baptist Church. Pastor Ely.
Let us bow. Our Father, we thank you for allowing us to be here today. We know that before the foundation of the world, you had this day already planned for those who will be sworn in. We thank you for preparing each individual that will represent our community and represent our city. We thank you for every trial and hurdle they had to cross that enabled them to be ready to handle the trials of governing our city. We thank you for every triumph they have experienced that has taught them how to thirst for victory. Your word tells us in 1 Timothy 2:2 to pray for kings and all those in authority that we may live peaceful, quiet lives in godliness and holiness. So we pray for protection from attacks from the enemy. We pray for power to press toward the goals and progress of our city. We pray for perseverance to endure the journey that is set before them. We ask you, our Father, to keep them close and watch over them. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you very much, Pastor Ely. Greatly appreciate it. It's now my honor to introduce to you a friend of mine. This is a man who in the last 4 years has completely changed the face of Kansas City and how we feel. You know, I've lived here all my life, and it's kind of been one of the local things to be down on ourselves about what we're not. Mayor James, through his passionate leadership, through his cheerleading, and through his ability to build consensus, has flipped that and has changed to where now Kansas City is a source of pride. With that, I would like to introduce to you Mayor Sly James.
Mayor James, if you raise your right hand, please. When I'm done, just say I do. Okay. I do solemnly swear that I possess all qualifications of the office of mayor under the Charter of Kansas City, Missouri, adopted by the vote of the people of said city, August 8, 2006, and all subsequent amendments thereto, and am not subject to any disqualifications in said charter named, that I will support the Constitution and laws of the United States and of the State of Missouri, that I will observe the provisions of the Charter and ordinances of Kansas City, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of the office, so help me God.
I do.
You are sworn in.
Thank you.
I'm sorry.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to introduce to you Mayor Sly James.
Thank you, Your Speaker.
Yeah. Please be seated. That's great. Good morning, and thanks to everybody for being here today. You know, it's a special honor and a distinct privilege to stand before you and again take the office to serve as your mayor. I really can't believe how fast the last 4 years have come and gone. It's kind of a reminder to me that time can pass us by if we're too idle, but opportunities can be missed if we're too slow. The key is to keep moving forward with conviction and to not waver when things get tough and times appear to be working against you. That's my thought this Saturday morning as I welcome back three incumbent council members and welcome nine newly elected council members, and welcome also to the management and staff of our city departments, Troy Schulte, great city manager, friend. Bill Geary, our city attorney, and a person who keeps us out of trouble. But also welcome to all the fellow citizens and families and friends and guests as we embark upon this new city council term. Well, special welcome to Mike Sanders, the county executive who has worked with us closely from day one. Now collectively, our new city council and I aim to meet and exceed your expectations for a greater Kansas City. We have high expectations to meet, thanks to the work and success of our last council and their focus on making Kansas City best. That council did some extraordinary things. They came to the table after a tough term, and they put their heads down, they focused, we got things done, and we did it by working together. I have a special place in my heart for the members of that council. I thank you, I will miss you, but enjoy your retirement. I also want to recognize Bonnie Mims, a state representative who I believe is here, and others, if I've missed, I apologize. For starters, let's continue to create a city where high expectations are the norm. And for starters, let's continue to create a culture of improving educational opportunities for our children. Everyone knows that this city has no direct control over the 15 school districts or the dozens of charter and private schools that educate our children. But that fact alone does not relieve us of our civic and our governmental responsibility to do all that we can to provide for the welfare of our children. It was for that very reason that I hired an education advisor for the mayor's office and started Turn to Page KC in 2011. In the next 4 years, we'll continue to work towards the goal of making sure every third grader can read at third grade level by the time they finish third grade. We want them to have the best possible chance to succeed, and to do that by using education as a tool that gets them there. We'll also continue to encourage our schools to innovate in ways that produce more quality seats for the children of our community, and to strive for world-class education for every child, regardless of race, color, economics, gender, orientation, or zip code. We can target issues that all districts in our city face to some extent, like student mobility, to ensure that no child falls through the cracks.
Why? Because education is Kansas City's best economic development tool. It certainly changed my life, and I believe that it has the power to change others as well. We need a vibrant economy with great economic activity that enables citizens to work, play, and live in this city that they love. We set the stage for that with Advance KC, which brings focus, breadth, and energy to our economic development efforts. We've made announcements about two new grocery stores east of Truce that will bring much-needed fresh food to those neighborhoods. In the past few years, downtown has taken off by virtue of the Sprint Center, the Kauffman Center for Performing Arts, Power and Light District, Union Station, and the Crossroads, a unique blend of arts, business, social interaction, winning attention from across the nation. Today, the final rail has been welded and the wires are going up on 2.2-mile-long streetcar project. This long-awaited addition to our city center already has attracted $1.3 billion of new investment since 2012 when KC Streetcar was first announced. When it opens next year, I am absolutely positive that the streetcar will magnify the energy that's already driving growth and bringing more visitors to Kansas City, as evidenced by our growing hotel occupancy numbers over the last year. We look forward to breaking ground soon on a new convention center hotel that will welcome more and larger conventions and meetings and generate some jobs here in Kansas City. We welcome Google Fiber and created and fostered a technological infrastructure that will nourish the city's entrepreneurial roots. The tech community, in fact, has been one of our best success stories over the past few years. And yet there is more ahead than with the Smart and Connected Cities program and project that's being built along the KC Streetcar line and route. So going forward, we're going to focus on how we can use that framework to start and grow more businesses and jobs throughout the city. And we must focus on what makes Kansas City unique, our central location, our job training programs like Launch Code and Tech Hire, our vibrant arts and cultural sector, and of course, our plain old Midwestern grit. Now, as I've said, Kansas City is quickly becoming synonymous with technological innovation. Technological advancement also implies greater efficiency, and we have a good start on that within our city government. We've established the position of Chief Innovation Officer. We undertook a whole set of initiatives to improve efficiency, including the Innovation Partnership, KC Stat, Digital Roadmap, and the Open Data Portal and online business permitting processes. I'm proud that Kansas City government buildings are among the very first and the leaders in our community to take the energy challenge to encourage energy efficiency, cost savings, and cleaner air in Kansas City. The challenge going forward will be to make sure that this improved efficiency benefits every neighborhood and every citizen in every corner of this city. By collecting, sharing, and analyzing data from all sources, we enable better results-oriented decisions for healthy living, livable and prosperous neighborhoods, businesses and institutions, and citizens. The Citizens Commission on Municipal Revenue that I appointed back in 2011 provided us with a fantastic financial map that we rely on and use to this day. We've established a 5-year financial plan that forms the backbone of every yearly budget and sets a course for future years. The foundation of these past 4 years stabilizes the city's budgetary requirements and creates additional opportunities to maximize the value of tax dollars as we move forward. Now, it might not be the sexiest topic for a Saturday morning, but government efficiency can sure be felt on every street corner in this city. And that's particularly true when that increased efficiency frees up more resources for us to make those streets more livable, welcoming, and safe. None of what we do works, however, if we have a city where people feel unsafe and insecure on our streets and our parks, at work, at school, or church, or in their homes. In the past 4 years, our police department, under the tremendous leadership of Chief of Police Daryl Forte, has greatly improved the relationships with our citizens. And working with partners such as Jean Peters Baker, Tammy Dickinson, ATF, FBI, UMKC, Probation and Parole, Mothers in Charge, and others, we established KC Nova, a focused deterrence approach to reducing violent crime. That is a huge part of why in 2014 we had the lowest number of homicides in 42 years. We're not done. We have a lot more to do. Homicides this year are on pace to approximate the reduction that we saw in 2014, but 3/4 of those homicides were committed in Kansas City this year involved a firearm. Never again do I want to spend a Sunday morning with Chief Forte outside a home in the inner city where a family whose child was killed in a drive-by shooting. That's the sort of horror that we cannot have in Kansas City, and we certainly don't want. So I assure you I will ask the entire City Council to join with me in continuing to press for all the changes that we need to make Kansas City as safe as it can possibly be for every single person who lives here. Education, employment, efficiency, and enforcement have been the cornerstones of my vision for a truly great Kansas City since before I was elected in 2011. And as we move forward, we have new challenges to face if we're going to continue our upward ascent and taking our place at the table of the great cities of this country. Thanks to the hard work of Mayor Pro Tem Cindy Serco and others, our housing stock is no longer subject to a receivership that lasted 10 years. As a result, more and more investments in housing on the east side are being made in Beacon Hill, the Colonnade, Seven Oaks, and elsewhere. After a study by the Aviation Department, the Citizens Committee, and a continuing study by the airlines, we know that Kansas City International Airport needs to change in some way, and that the airlines have said to us that doing nothing is not an option. How that happens will be a subject of much debate. Through programs we have established and sustained, like the Youth Commission, Youth Services Roundtable, Mayor's Nights, Club KC, Bright Futures, we have identified ways for young people to become active and engaged members of this community. Our new City Council Youth Development Committee will develop strategies for how we as a city government can increase educational and employment opportunities for teenagers and young adults in this city, and to provide them with the tools that they need to succeed and have a successful life, not someplace else, but right here in Kansas City. We've made significant progress in the last 4 years, and things are happening. People are talking about us around the world and the country. The initials KC are as hot as Johnny Cueto's fastball. The Royals went to the World Series last year, and this year they're going to win it. And then the Chiefs are going to march towards a championship along with Sporting KC. And then we can all ascend into heaven because life will be no better ever than that. So despite all the feel-good moments, the gains and investments over the last 4 years, we still have much work to do. And we're not done yet if we want a city that has safe neighborhoods, world-class schools, abundant cultural opportunities, and a high quality of life. 4 years ago, I told you that we want every neighborhood, every part of town, every business, every community group, every person to remember that we are one city. I said we would think about Kansas City as a community that gives no favor and tolerates no disfavor based on whether you are white, black, brown, young, old, rich, poor, gay, straight, Northlander, Midtowner, or Southsider. We cannot and will not discount any Kansas City or any group in this city or any part of Kansas City without diminishing the greatness of the whole. As a council, I pledge an attitude of fearlessness when we confront the challenges that our community faces, but I also pledge an attitude of pride for all the successes that we have shared and will share. So today, we renew our laser focus on the vision that we have to make Kansas City best. And to this, I pledge my very best effort as your mayor, each and every day. For those who know me, they know that there is no greater honor that I have, no greater pride that I hold, than to be able to work on behalf of the city that I've loved my entire life. I don't believe in games. I don't believe in politics. I believe in results. So to this, I would ask your fervent and sincere support as your new city council and I begin our time together. And with your support and our best efforts and God's good grace, we will succeed. So thank you for being here today. Hang around and have some fun with us, and let's make Kansas City best. Thank you very much.
I should have learned my lesson to never go on after the mayor, but. All right, thank you very much, Mayor. Now to round out the team, I would like to introduce to you the City Council for 2015 to 2019. I will call your names. Please join me up on stage at your seat. These 12 people have accepted the challenge to be leaders within our community, and the voters have elected them. The job they have taken is extremely difficult. Even getting the job is difficult. Campaigns are a lot of work. They have put forth the work, they've come forward with good ideas, and now they are getting ready to lead the city. So with that, I would like to introduce First District at Large and Mayor Pro Tem Scott Wagner. First District, Heather Hall. Second District at Large, Teresa Lohr. Second District, Dan Fowler. Third District at Large, Quentin Lucas. Third District, Jermaine Reed. Fourth District at Large, Catherine Shields. Fourth District, Jolie Justice. Fifth District at Large, Lee Barnes. Fifth District, Alicia Canaday. Sixth District at Large, Scott Taylor.
Good job, sir. Good job. Good job. Thank you.
Sixth District, Kevin McManus. I'd like to call back to the stage Marilyn Sanders, City Clerk of Kansas City, Missouri, who will now administer the oath of office to our incoming City Council members.
I do solemnly swear that I possess all qualifications under the office of Council Member. Under the Charter of Kansas City, Missouri, adopted by the vote of the people of said city, August 8, 2006, and all subsequent amendments thereto, and am not subject to any disqualifications in said charter named, that I will support the Constitution and laws of the United States and of the state of Missouri, that I will observe the provisions of the Charter and ordinances of Kansas City, and that I will faithfully discharge the duties of said office. So help me God.
I do.
You are sworn in.
Ladies and gentlemen, your mayor and your city council. Thank you.
Thank you very much. After the benediction, please remain in the auditorium for a brief legislative session. Meeting is required by law, and the City Council will consider two minor housekeeping issues that allow them to begin their work next week. Also, please join the Mayor and Council immediately following the inauguration for a celebration of food and music in the pavilion across the street at the American Jazz Museum. The Mayor and Council will be here taking some pictures and will join us across the street shortly. The Negro Leagues Baseball Museum also is having a Heart of America Hot Dog Festival today, and they know we're going to crash it, so you are all welcome to go over to that. The Mayor will officially open the festival, and a very special guest, C.J. Walker, will provide the music. And you and your families are welcome to stay for the festival and enjoy the entire day. You can leave here, run home, and grab your family and come back. It should be a lot of fun. Now, providing our benediction is Imam Soleiman from the Al-Haq Islamic Center.
Our Honorable Mayor, distinguished members of the City Council, public officials, panelists, and the citizens of Kansas City, good morning. God's peace be with you. Please join me for the benediction. With the name of the Creator, who is the Lord, Guardian, Evolver, and Cherisher of all that is in creation, both the animate and inanimate things, all people, all systems of knowledge, and of all the worlds. We ask you to help us to realize that regardless of what name we call you by, you are our Lord, the Creator of us all. And you hear and answer the prayers of all of those that call upon you. So cause us, dear Lord, to have the discipline to also answer your call when we are called to that which gives us life. Our Lord, it is you alone that we worship, and we understand that it is upon you that we should rely for guidance, direction, and protection. For although there are those that might offer us guidance, direction, and protection, we understand that you are the best of those to guide, to give direction, and you are the best of protectors. Our Lord, we humbly pray that you bless our mayor, the Honorable Sly James, and the members of this City Council to lead and govern our great city, Kansas City, in the best of fashions. Please make pure their hearts and their intentions so they will represent the best interest of all of the citizens of Kansas City. Protect them from succumbing to their own self-interest or the influences of those that would prefer business as usual, as opposed to working diligently to continue making this city a city that represents all that is fair and just in all respects. In other words, bless them to keep making Kansas City a model city for every other city in this great nation. Our Lord, guide their thinking, inspire their actions, and shower them with your help and your protection. Our Lord, help us, the citizens of Kansas City, come to realize that Kansas City can never become the model city through the work and governance of Mayor Sly James and the City Council alone. For in order for Kansas City to truly become a model city, it must be inhabited by model citizens who are working cooperatively with the mayor and the City Council to assure the best reality for all citizens. Inspire us then, Lord, to take some personal responsibility for ourselves, for our families, our neighborhoods, our communities. Give us the spirit to become more charitable, the spirit for volunteerism, for being our brother's keeper. Bless us to go back to the village that raises our children together, keeping them from harm and ensuring for them the best chance for a bright future. Motivate us to become more civically engaged, holding ourselves and our leaders accountable for creating the reality that we all say that we want for this great city. If we work together and we keep our faith in you, we know that you will bless us to continue making Kansas City a city of security, a city of peace, a city of equal opportunity, a city of progress, and a shining example of the vision held by the founding fathers of this great nation. Amen.
All right, thank you very much. Again, please remain seated. We're going to start an official City Council legislative session. Will the clerk, Marilyn Sanders, please return to the stage?
What'd you say? Mayor James, with your permission, we'd like to go ahead and start with the session, please. Okay. We'll bring the meeting to order.
The first meeting of the Kansas City, Missouri City Council for 2015 and beyond is now in order. Will the clerk please call the roll?
Wagner?
Here.
Hall?
Here.
Fowler?
Here.
Lohr?
Here.
Lucas?
Here.
Reed?
Present.
Shields?
Here.
Justice?
Here.
Barnes?
Present.
Kennedy?
Here.
Taylor?
Here.
McManus?
Here.
James?
Here.
13 members present.
Will the clerk please call resolutions for immediate adoption?
150648, amending the standing rules of the City Council by repealing set rule 10.01 entitled Standing Committees and enacting a new 10.01 entitled Standing Committees and assigning current ordinances and appropriate committee to the appropriate committees to reflect the Council Committee organization beginning August 1, 2015.
Mayor Pro Tem.
Mr. Mayor, I move the resolution 150649 be adopted.
It's been moved and seconded that resolution 150649 be adopted. Is there any discussion? I have some. Surprise. The structure of city council committees has been the subject of much media discussion. So let me talk about the real reasons why we did what we did, not the ones that they've conjured up. First of all, if we have issues in this city that need to be addressed, the only way that they're going to be addressed is if we focus attention on them. And having things bound up in other committees where they are only second place issues is not sufficient. We have heard from neighbors and citizens across the city time after time after time that housing is an issue that needs to be addressed. And where is that housing mostly located? In the 3rd and the 5th districts. So we broke out housing. We made it a special committee because I want to make sure that this council is looking at housing, looking at homelessness, looking at vacant structures, looking at things that actually matter, and this is not a second thought or an afterthought. This is a committee set up to have one function, and that's to look at housing. And over the next 4 years, we expect to have something done and some progress made. And if we didn't make it a special issue, I'm not sure that we would have gotten there. We broke ethics out of finance, governance, and ethics because, frankly, we didn't do anything with the ethics and finance governance anyhow. And we've got 8 lawyers in this group. And it made sense to put ethics with a group of people who live with a fairly stringent ethical code with the legal review committee. Makes perfectly good sense. Neither of them will meet on a regular basis. They will meet on an ad hoc basis or an as needed basis. And that's why we did that. We combine neighborhoods and public safety because neighborhoods should be publicly safe. We put people in that committee who had expressed time and time again on the committee trail that they were all about neighborhoods. They were all about neighborhoods. They were all about neighborhoods. So Alicia Kennedy, Catherine Shields will chair and co-chair that neighborhood committee. We expanded small business committee because small business committee needs to expand its scope. We have a huge entrepreneurial issue in this city that needs to be addressed in terms of finding more capital. That's not something that you're going to do as just an afterthought. That has to be intentional. We also want to focus on jobs. So the new small business committee is small business, entrepreneurship, and jobs, because we want to make sure that we're making progress in all of those areas. We have an airport committee broken out from transportation and infrastructure. Why? Because we have an airport issue. And we need to have a discussion about that issue. And I wanted somebody in that committee, somebody who's leading that committee, who I know has a proven track record of being able to focus on facts and data, but also to keep people moving in the right direction. And that's why Jolie Justice is chairing that. The legislative committee was a no-brainer. We got a person who was just a state senator, another who was just a state rep. It makes sense that they chair legislative issues, talking about state legislation and federal legislation. Last committee, one that is especially important to me, youth development. This is a situation in this city where we have to focus on the youth of this city in all ways. We've been intentional about that since 2011 when I started Turn to Page KC, when we started Club KC, when we saw crime in juvenile areas go down 16% and 18% as a result of those activities during the summer, where we need to make sure that children coming out of our neighborhoods, all of our neighborhoods, have access to summer jobs and employment and job training skills. So, if it's important enough for me to want to chair it myself, it should be fairly important as to who I pick to be my vice chair, and that's why I picked Catherine Shields. We have a lot of different skill sets in this council. My job is to try to find the way to use those skill sets to maximum effectiveness and efficiency. We're going to try this for a while. We're going to work together for a while. We're going to focus on those issues that these committees are set up to focus on. It wasn't for power. It was for effectiveness. I don't care about the power. I got all the power I need. Ask my wife and daughter. They'll tell you that when I go home, I have nothing. My concern is very simple. I have 4 years left to do and complete some of those things that are important to this city. Housing. Safety, making sure that we're doing everything that we can to create jobs, making sure that we spread economic development across the entire city. Those are the things that I care about. That's why these people are in the positions that they're in, and that's why I'm betting that they're going to help us succeed. So, beyond that, anybody who has an issue with why I did it, speculate all you want. But it's going to be my goal, and this is the first sign that you have, that when we have issues, we're going to talk about them open and honestly, we're going to confront them, and we're going to explain ourselves. And that's why I'm explaining this now. So if there's no further discussion on this issue, will the clerk please call the roll?
Wagner.
Aye.
Hall.
Aye.
Fowler.
Aye.
Lohr.
Aye.
Lucas.
Aye.
Reed.
Aye.
Shields.
Aye.
Justice.
Aye.
Barnes.
Aye.
Kennedy.
Aye.
Taylor.
Aye.
McManus. James?
Aye.
13 ayes.
The resolution is passed. Councilman Wagner?
Mr. Mayor, move that the. Actually, Mayor, I need you to call for first reading.
Where are we?
Ready?
Yes, go ahead.
150649, repealing section 2-49 Code of Ordinances entitled Order of Succession of the Elected Officials and enacting a new section 2-49 entitled Order of Succession for Elected Officials to reflect the Council's organization beginning August 1, 2015.
Mayor Pro Tem.
Mr. Mayor, I move that the charter requirement that ordinances be read on three separate occasions be waived and that this ordinance be advanced for final reading and consideration at this time.
It's been moved and seconded that the charter requirement for reading of ordinances on three separate days be waived and that this ordinance be advanced for final reading and consideration at this time. Is there any discussion on that motion? Hearing no discussion on the motion, the clerk will call the roll on the motion.
Wagner.
Aye.
Hall.
Aye.
Fowler.
Aye.
Lohr.
Aye.
Lucas.
Aye.
Reed.
Aye.
Shields.
Aye.
Justice.
Aye.
Barnes.
Aye.
Kennedy.
Aye.
Taylor.
Aye.
McManus. James?
Aye.
13 ayes.
The motion is passed. The ordinance is now before council for final consideration. Is there any discussion on the ordinance as considered? Mayor Pro Tem.
Mr. Mayor, this ordinance provides for the succession of office to office of the mayor should the mayor and mayor pro tem be out of the city or otherwise incapacitated. This ordinance follows the current ordinance but uses the new names of committees and adds the new standing committees we just established by the amendment to the standing rules.
Is there any further discussion? If not, the clerk will call the roll on the ordinance.
Wagner.
Aye.
Hall.
Aye.
Fowler.
Aye.
Lohr.
Aye.
Lucas. Reed.
Aye.
Shields.
Aye.
Justice.
Aye.
Barnes.
Aye.
Kennedy.
Aye.
Taylor.
Aye.
McManus.
Aye.
James.
Aye.
13 ayes.
The ordinance is passed. Is there any additional business to come before the body?
Mr. Mayor, with your permission, we have a parting prayer before the adjournment of the City Council.
Absolutely.
Will you please stand for Apostle Reverend Reginald E. Stevens from the Come Up Higher Ministries International.
Can we just celebrate? I just want to take a time. Can we just celebrate this council, our mayor? Come on, come on, you can do better than that. Come on, come on. There is something really special happening in this room right before us on this great occasion that we're a part of. Isn't it amazing what God is doing with us even right now? I tell you, Mayor, we are excited about Kansas City and about what God is getting ready to do through this wonderful council. Congratulations to all of you. Amen. We praise God for you. Amen. We pray that God would empower you. Amen. Come on, give it up one more time. One more time. I break the norm. I'm sorry, I break the norm. Amen. Can you just do this real quick while we're here? Just high five somebody and tell them progress, progress, progress. Come on, tell them, turn to your other neighbor, tell them progress, progress, progress. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Come on, let us pray. Let us pray so we can go get on those hot dogs and crash that hot dog party. Amen. All right, praise the Lord. Come on, let's bow our heads. Father, we just come and say thank you. My God, you have just shown yourself so strong in this room on this afternoon. We thank you for what our eyes have seen and what our ears have heard and what our hearts have been made to feel. God, we realize that, God, this is a special occasion with the inaugural of our mayor, Sly James, the council, and all that are before us, God. We see that you have great things in store for us, and we just ask that you would bless us. I'm reminded of Jesus Christ when he had actually got his inaugural team in place, if you will, and he had appointed his 120. Amen. And he sent them up into the upper room, and he told them to remain there. And the Bible indicated that while they were sitting there, that the Spirit of the Lord came down on each one of them and empowered them. And it said the main thing that really spoke loud to me, Father, was the fact that when they were sitting there on one accord. My prayer is that this team, God, would be unified at all times, because it's going to be through unity that they're going to be able to succeed in what you have put before them. Now, God, I pray for the empowerment of this city. I pray that, God, that as you move us forward, God, that we embark upon all the great things that you have for our city, for this council, and for our mayor. Now, Father, we thank you and we praise you. Can you say this with me real quick? Coming together, is a beginning. Staying together is progress. Working together is success. In Jesus' name, amen.
If there is no further business to come before the body, is there a motion to adjourn? Well, that was weak. I guarantee you, after a few legislative meetings, you'll be jumping to say, so moved. All in favor?
Aye.
We're adjourned. Join us across the street. Help us celebrate.